But at least let me finish the point I'm making. What I'm saying is that the Christians, on the other hand, you see the Jews reject him, but the Christians take the other extreme. They raise him to the standard of God, to the level of God, and God himself. And the Muslims, we take the middle ground. We do not completely reject him, nor do we put him to the level of God. We accept him to be one of the mightiest messengers of God. He's born of a virgin, Mary. He's basically a messiah of God, and he's one of the mightiest messengers of God.
Mormons have introduced Jesus.
Yeah, but we're not talking Jesus. I'm talking about the real Jesus.
Jesus is
Isa alayhi salam. The real Jesus.
You know what actually?
Why? Who converted to Christianity? Jesus converted from what to Christianity? Wait, he converted from what to Christianity?
Jesus was born a Jew, and the Jewish people killed him because he converted to Christianity.
What makes you think he converted to Christianity? Honestly, I want to know what part of the Bible tells you that he converted. No. What part of the Bible tells you that he converted to Christianity?
Ask her, what is Christianity?
So basically, the God of Jesus was born a Jew, and then he converted to Christianity.
Ask her, what is
Christianity? This is just modern.
Ask her.
Do you have the word Christianity in the Bible?
Is she Christian?
Do you have the word Christianity in the Bible?
No.
Messiah. Ask the Messiah. You see, even the word Christianity is not there.
Ask her if she's Christian.
This is your religion.
Look, I was raised as a Christian, alright? What you're saying is completely out of nonsense.
Yes.
It doesn't make sense.
You are saying, are you Christian? Are you Christian?
No, she's confused.
Listen.
No, sorry. It's
not your business.
I'm not asking you for that reason. You're questioning me. No, you.
I believe in one God, so it's
that's
one
fine. I'm not asking you.
So do we.
Do you believe in the Trinity? Do you believe in the Trinity?
No.
Yes, sir.
Can I just interject, please? Christianity is called Christianity because they follow Christ.
No, it doesn't make sense.
This label was given later.
He brought the religion, okay? He says it's not just for the Jewish, but also for the Gentiles.
I think Hashem done the damage.
The people that followed him before the sacrifice, they were Jewish. Jesus was not a Messiah. Jesus
was not a Jew. We should get the umbrella, people.
Yeah, you cannot.
They get a massive umbrella.
Those are the Jewish. Don't speak to me.
Every time I read the Quran. God speaks to me every time I read the Quran.
My friend,
no, he's not a Christian.
Other people come. Does God speak to you? Does God speak to you?
Last night.
He speaks to you.
Can anybody hear the voice of God on this?
Excuse me. Holy Spirit, you do not understand. I'm a Christian.
We're reading the Quran last night. We could hear God's words.
On a one-to-one. God speaks to me as a one-to-one relationship. When I read the Bible, I find God spoke to Abraham. He spoke to Isaac. He spoke to Jacob. Yeah? He spoke to all the prophets. What I find in a Muslim. Yeah?
He spoke to Muhammad.
He spoke to Muhammad. Did God speak to you directly?
Can I answer?
Yes.
Have I not answered already?
Not through the Quran. Does God speak to you directly?
Okay. First and foremost.
When I come before my maker and I say, Lord God, speak to me. I need help. I need strength. God has done miracles in my life. He's strength like
So you Christians are speaking to each other. That's fine. You can convince each other. No problem. Convince the converted.
Any Muslim here say that God speaks to them?
You know what the Bible says? Does the Bible not say anyone who hears the Bible, anyone who hears the voice of God, will they live? Ask him.
Why is he
alive? Because it's Jesus.
I'm asking you.
Why did God speak to Abraham?
That's anyone who hears.
Why did God speak to Abraham? Because he had a relationship. He knew him. Why did God speak to not this man? Because he does not know God.
Did I say he didn't speak to me? Did I say that? I said every day he speaks to me through the Quran when I read it. Okay, now let me this. You said your God speaks to you, right? In what language does he speak to you?
God speaks many languages.
No, but you don't understand all the
God speaks many languages. He has many children.
How many languages do you speak?
How many languages do I need to speak? God speaks to me.
No, you speak.
He speaks to me in the one language I need to know.
Which is? English.
Which is? The language that God needs to speak to me.
In the Bible, does it say you cannot hear the voice of God in
me?
No, it does not.
Does it not say that?
No.
Okay. Yeah. When you say God speaks to you, okay. Who is it? Is it Jesus, the Holy Spirit, or the Father? Not the Holy Spirit.
Jesus Christ.
Not the Holy Spirit?
Jesus Christ.
I'm asking you. I heard you. Okay. So Jesus speaks to you. That's fine. Jesus speaks to you. But does the Holy Spirit speak to you?
Yes.
Does the Holy Spirit speak to you?
The Bible says that the Holy Spirit leads you to all truth. He is the comforter.
But does he speak to you?
Yes.
So Jesus speaks to you,
yes.
The Holy Spirit speaks to you, yes. Who else speaks to you?
Who else speaks to you? You're speaking to
me. How about the Father? Does the Father speak to you?
No.
Why not?
Well, because Jesus Christ is the mediator. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 5.
A mediator between you and God.
One mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus.
Thank you, I rest my case. So he actually admitted Jesus is the mediator, not God.
Ambassador.
Thank you very much.
John 8:58.
You know, that's why sometimes I let them talk.
John 8.
Because they answer the question themselves.
John 8, when you read John 8:58, yeah. And you read down, he said, we are not stoning you because you are a mere man. We are stoning you because you claim to be the Son of God. You read this.
By the way, that is John 10:32.
No, that's John 8:58.
Go read John 10:32.
Okay, that should be another one as well then.
Maybe there is.
It's before Abraham was born, I am. When you read down further down, it says, we are not stoning you for the miracles you are doing. We are stoning you because you are mere man, claim to be God.
That is whose allegation? The Jewish people allegation. Did the Jews also call him a fool? So anything the Jews call him, that doesn't mean it's true. You see, this is a false allegation and accusation made against Jesus that he's claiming to be God when he never ever claimed to be God. You can find a clear answer to that question of the Jews, that accusation of the Jews, that you being a mere man are claiming to be God. You know what Jesus answered them? He said they, the judges, the Jews, in Psalm 82:6, is referring to them, they were called gods, the sons of the Most High. Read Psalm 82:6.
But
I'm answering that. That's what I'm telling you. God speaks to me.
Understand.
I've already told you. God speaks to me.
You know, when you read a newspaper, it speaks to you because you're reading a newspaper. Yeah. If you read a newspaper,
you got it.
That's not speaking to you. That's not God speaking to you.
When you read the book,
listen. That's not God
speaking.
Listen.
When you read a book written by an author, it is the author speaking to you. You realize that?
What about God himself?
God himself, if he spoke to you, you wouldn't be living, trust me.
Why not?
Because you'll be dead.
No, you got it wrong. The Bible says, you say, if you don't, we can look at the face of God and live. Not God speak to you.
Oh, so you can't see God?
I didn't say I could see God.
So you can hear him. How do you know it is God then? Maybe it might be the devil. It might be the devil. How do you know?
God has changed my life.
Many Hindus say that life has been changed. Why not? How can you say that is God speaking to you just because you hear voices in your head? That is actually an illness. You should go and see a psychiatrist.
How was Muhammad sure that he met an angel or a devil in disguise?
I'll tell you. I'll tell you what. Every ayah that we read, when we read the Quran, you know how we start the Quran? A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, which means cursed. May the Satan be cursed. Wait a minute. You know what?
Look.
You ask me a question, let me answer.
Can Satan heal?
Can I ask? Don't go to another topic. You ask me a question, allow me to answer. Okay. You always do
Satan,
this.
Satan,
whenever you ask question, you don't let me finish. No, let me finish.
Never heal.
Let me finish.
Satan does not have healing.
When the Quran starts with, may the Satan be cursed. Do you really think this is an inspiration by the Satan? No.
But Muhammad himself said.
How shall I show you? Because he wants me to. Do you know why I think that the Bible has been inspired by the devil? Do you know why? Because in the Bible, you know who is the God of the earth? Which he actually confirmed last time he was speaking. It is the devil, Satan, who is the Lord of the world. And you know who is cursed? In the Bible, in Galatians 3:13, you know it. Who is cursed? Jesus. Jesus, according to Galatians chapter 3 verse 13, is cursed. So the devil is the Lord of the world, and Jesus Christ is cursed. My prophet, my messenger, my Messiah has been actually blasphemed against in the Bible.
Adam,
he has been accused of being cursed. Now wait. No, I'll let you explain. Let me finish.
Adam, the day he disobeyed God and obeyed Satan, from that time he started, that time he lost. He sinned, he committed sin. From that time he started worshipping Satan.
Why is Jesus cursed?
So that is why they are away from God. And
why is Jesus cursed?
Satan is ruling the world.
Not God. Not God. He's Satan is ruling the world. So now you know who inspired the Bible. That is a clear-cut evidence that the Satan inspired the Bible. He, Satan, is ruling his world. My Allah rules the Satan and the world.
Why there is no peace? Why there is a war? Because of your messenger.
Because Jesus says, I've not come for peace. Jesus, in Matthew 10:34, says, I've not come to bring peace, but the sword. Now you tell me this is Jesus, who according to you was supposed to be loving. But he himself says, I've not come to bring peace, but to bring the sword. Yes? Basically a man against a woman, the parents against the parents.
The word of God.
The sword.
The
sword
is
the word of God. Word of God. So your word of God is the sword.
Which Muhammad used to kill the
Jews and
Christians.
Read Matthew 10:34. Read Matthew 10:34. You tell me it's not true.
That's not the sword.
Why didn't you put it in context? Did Jesus come for peace? Answer, Christians, come on, why are you crying now? So Jesus lied, and he said, according to Jesus' lied. When Jesus says, I have not come to bring peace, that means peace. Seriously, man.
Who testified Jesus Christ have to go through a lot of fights.
Did Jesus not say he's not come for bring peace?
People have to go through a lot of persecution. That's what Jesus said.
Did he come to bring peace?
He came to bring peace.
So he lied when he said this.
There is difference between God, peace, and earthly peace. What is the peace, Allah? There is a peace.
So you're saying earthly peace? Yeah. There's no peace because Jesus came here. Wow. That is even worse.
We have another one. And love your God with all your heart. That's it.
I love that preaching of the Christians, but Jesus actually disproves you. When he says, I've not come to bring peace, but the sword. Matthew 10:34. Give me a Bible, I'll show you. Give me a Bible.
You're twisting.
I tell you what, you put it in context. You put it in context.
All of you disciples. All
of you. He ran away. He ran away. So Jesus is saying, I've not come to bring peace. They are telling me he came to bring peace.
Jesus came
one
to
of them
peace.
Is lying, and I know it's not Jesus.
Hashem, you are thinking John 14:27.
What I'm saying?
John 14:27.
Have you read Matthew 10:34? No, because we were discussing that verse. Have you read Matthew 10:34? I'll come to that. Have you read Matthew 10:34? No, you don't want to read.
What is the sword?
The reason you guys are embarrassed, and you don't read it.
What is the sword? The word of God. What is the sword? He has come to bring a sword. I've come to bring a sword.
What is the sword?
Word of God. Yes.
So what will the sword do? Will it divide people or join? Will it unite them?
All of
the word of God divides them. According
why
to them.
Divided? What?
I don't
why
want such a divided? Word of God. Please. Because why that God is divided? A the Satan. Why because he's the one who is in charge of the earth according to them. And then Jesus is cursed in Galatians 3:13. I love Jesus. And I would never say he's cursed, but his Bible says he's cursed. Whom do you believe? Whom do you believe? The Christian or the Muslim?
We have to believe Christian because he became cursed for our sins.
What kind of a God becomes a curse?
Yes, of course.
What kind of a God becomes a curse?
It's our God.
Only the false God.
He came to serve.
Only the false God becomes a curse.
Anybody who denies Jesus Christ is all false.
My God is not a curse. My God is a blessing, not a curse.
Through Islam, through Catholics, through Jehovah's. The real Jesus, Bible Jesus.
The one who's cursed.
That's of the living God.
By the way, do not accuse my messenger and my prophet and my Messiah as a curse.
Muhammad is one of them.
According to the Bible, Jesus did not come for peace. That's for sure. Unless you're telling me Jesus is
a curse. There will be many false prophets and Muhammad is one of them.
Yes, I agree with that.
Yes.
Because he didn't know what's happening with himself in the Quran.
Okay. Why don't you preach to the Christian over there? Because I see you doing this every time. They preach to the converted, and we preach to the Christians their own Bible, which says Jesus is cursed. Look, none of them are defending that. None of them. Only a Muslim has to defend this.
Alhamdulillah. He became cursed.
See, you're agreeing with me actually. Then he became a curse.
In the Old Testament, the sheep were supposed to be sacrificed. So what they do is they go and touch the sheep. Jesus became cursed. Which, became cursed for us, their sin. For our transgression. That's what Jesus became. All the sins.
This is exactly what I'm saying. Thank you. He's agreeing with me. So he became the biggest curse in the world while taking everyone's sin on him. Yeah, go on.
You're saying all these things about other religions are not very positive.
I'm not doing. I'm here. It's not you.
How is your religion bringing peace in the world?
Okay, first.
Start
there. Ready to live in the Middle East? Well, you should know Abraham came before Moses. If he lived in the Middle East, he wasn't a Jew, trust me. You're still making the categorical mistake that he's a Jew.
Okay, you're kind of insulting. You're being insulting.
I'm not insulting, I'm telling you, I'm educating you about something, and you're being arrogant and saying I'm insulting you.
You're too arrogant in the debate.
I'm the one arrogant, calling Jesus is cursed, and he's calling me arrogant.
Keep on going asking, you never let us
ask. You know, with all due respect, if somebody teaches you something, then you should be humble. Yes, I can. I can. Like the way you keep saying Abraham is. Wait, wait. You keep saying Abraham. Abraham is a Jew.
No.
You keep saying this. He's not a Jew. I'm teaching you your own history.
Find Judaism.
And that is arrogance when you keep saying something is wrong and you keep repeating it. Doesn't make it true. That is arrogance. Okay. First and foremost, you ask me how do we establish peace in the world? Okay. It is not like the way Jesus says in Matthew 10:34. I've not come for peace. I've come to bring the sword. So it's not like that. In Islam, we are told to establish love and peace and honor within the society, be it between Muslims and even non-Muslims. However, we are told when somebody attacks you, when somebody oppresses you, you do not just turn the other cheek. That is not something which humanity, that is not something humanity has been accustomed to, and it's not justice either. Because imagine if the Jewish people who were oppressed by Hitler, yes? And you guys just sat around, yes? And the Americans and the British did nothing, and the other Europeans did nothing. Do you really think that would be love? No, it would not. If you follow the Bible, and if the Jewish people turn the other cheek and let them be massacred in these gas chambers, then that is not what my religion preaches, because that is not love, that is not peace, and that is not justice. Alhamdulillah, we are told to defend. We are told to defend the ones who are weak. If you are able to. And that is what the true message of the religion of God is. Not to turn the other cheek, which is impractical.
There's war between Saudi Arabia, Yemen. All the rich Saudis don't give any money to
politics, nothing to do with religion. Nothing to do with
Wait. Do you know the accounts of all the rich Saudi Arabians? Do you have access to the accounts? You made a bold statement that did not give any money to anyone, yes? I'm asking you, do you have access to any? To whom? Whom do they not give money to? Oh, please, you don't know much about Saudi Arabia. Exactly. But anyway, look here, I'm not going to politicize this, but if you must know, most of the refugees today are refugees because of the bombardment of the Christians. In Iraq, in Afghanistan, yes, the American army and the European army. When the truth comes out, they don't like it.
It's an internal politics.
Okay, so you're telling me, you're telling me those people in the army are not Christians. One at a time. Are you telling me those people who have enlisted in the army, in American army and European army, are not Christians? Is that what you're telling me? Are the people enlisted in the army, in the Air Force, in the military?
Don't blame American and European.
Yeah, the Americans do it the first time.
No?
The oil and the money started all this problem.
So why would I not blame them?
Don't blame my country for the war.
You're the American? You're the American? Why did they start the war in Iraq? Tell me.
Why? Because of oil and money.
So who's
that?
Who gave? Wait a minute. So you're giving me the reason. Wait a minute. I didn't ask you. Wait.
So
you're saying it is Iraq's fault. Let me ask you this. If you're an European Jew. Good, you admitted it. You just said it. You're a European Jew. That's fine. No problem. Even if you're a Jew, I won't treat you any differently. What I'm asking is this: when the Americans came with a false pretext to attack Iraq by saying that they had WMD, weapons of mass destruction, do you think that is the right thing to do?
No, it's not.
Good.
Right.
So we both agree.
It's not right to make a war anywhere. But don't blame American and European for the problem in the Middle East. Much before.
No.
From the beginning of time, there was war in the Middle East.
I'm not blaming anyone. What I'm saying is that the reason this majority Christian country, the Americans, Okay? And the coalition from the Europeans, when they joined them and they attacked Iraq, yes, on a false pretext, and they displaced thousands and millions of people and killed thousands of millions of people.
Why did the bombers come to the United States and then kill a bunch of innocent people?
Sorry, why did you come?
About
9/11. Oh, you never 9/11?
We never went.
That was an inside joke.
Wait, even if they did, listen. Wait a minute. Let's analyze that. You know those people, these 11 people or 9 people, whoever they were. You know, majority of them were Saudis. Yes. Whom did they attack? Whom did the Americans? No, Afghanistan. Yes. Why didn't they attack Saudi Arabia? Don't tell me that what you think and your perspective is right.
What about Israeli businessmen?
Why are you crying about 9/11? Who committed the atrocities? Hitler, before 9/11 happened. Hitler, yes, who is a Christian he was brought up as a Christian.
Not only in America.
And his army, the Germans, they were Christians. If you look at the graves today in Germany, there's a big cross on the grave. You know why? Because of Christians. The Europeans who massacred.
Christian, where are you, boss?
Really?
Hitler was never easy.
Why him?
He was a communist. According to him, according to Hitler, got married in the church. Why was he? Why did he get married in the church?
He was a communist. So what?
Why was
a Christian.
He's a communist.
Why was he baptized?
So don't defame.
Why was he baptized?
People who don't.
Why was Hitler baptized?
Christians.
He doesn't know. You know the reason.
Never ever.
The reason Hitler uses the cross.
Of Jesus
if you look at,
the devil's teaching is war and base war.
We have already seen the devil.
Jesus Christ taught us to forgive and forgive and only forgive.
We have already seen the devil calling Jesus Christ a curse in the Bible. So basically. These guys, they're embarrassed because we call the Nazis a Christian. Nazism actually originated from Christianity. You should realize
Muhammad entertained.
No, that is the ideology. I'm talking about the origins.
No. I don't believe that religion
believes. No, I don't agree with Hitler. Of course not.
Then you believe in
Hitler. I do not agree with Hitler. However, the army of Hitler, who were the Germans, they're buried under a cross. Why? Why? The reason you're quiet is because you know that is the truth. The reason you're quiet is because you know that's the truth.
No, that's a
Germans. The Germans who followed Hitler,
if you
they were Christians.
I will answer you.
They were Christians.
If you keep quiet, I will answer you.
Arisa was Christian.
They're communists.
They're not religious. Hitler was a dictator.
I agree he was a dictator. But you see, when Hitler was baptized in a church, and when he got married in a church, I know that his origins were Christian.
Christians do not dictate. Never.
Yeah, but dictator. Look, just because someone is a dictator doesn't mean they don't have a religion.
Just blaming Christians for everything.
Do you know Saddam Hussein was a dictator? Saddam Hussein was a dictator, but he's known as a Muslim. But do we agree with his actions? No, we don't.
He was the leader of Muslim Ummah.
You know, the only religion.
Osama bin Laden was the leader of Muslim Ummah.
He wasn't the leader of Muslim.
Osama bin Laden.
Utter lie.
Yeah.
Utter lie. Okay, which country was he the ruler of? Wait, let's see. Which country was Osama bin Laden?
Answer now. Answer.
Afghanistan. Answer. Afghanistan.
Oh,
answer.
Afghanistan. Was he the president? Yeah.
Afghanistan.
Was he the president?
Yeah.
He was the
leader of a Muslim Ummah.
Is Afghanistan the Ummah? Is Afghanistan the Ummah? What happened? Is Afghanistan the Ummah?
According to Quran.
He is the leader of a Muslim Ummah.
You said he's the leader of Afghanistan. Make up your mind.
He lived in Afghanistan. He was the well-known person in Afghanistan.
Of course he was well-known. So was Hitler.
So he was the chosen leader of Muslim Ummah.
And which Ummah accepted him?
Every Muslim Ummah.
Okay, give me one leader who accepted him. Go on. Let's see if he knows. Why swallowing your spit now? Tell me.
No.
Why swallowing your spit? Which leader?
Every.
Which leader? Give me one name.
Every.
Give me one name.
The Muslim called him in Pakistan.
Give me the name. Give me the name.
Yeah, Muslim.
So Ziaul-Haq. Ziaul-Haq. Are you saying Ziaul-Haq accepted
him? Yes. Yes.
He's a liar. He's a liar. You see, this is what we deal with. The Christian hecklers.
Yeah,
they're not only hecklers, but they're liars.
He hired him.
Who hired him?
Yeah. Ziaul-Haq.
So who's the leader?
He hired
Wait
him.
Wait a minute, so who's the leader? Wait a minute, watch this.
He was the president.
No, you he said Ziaul-Haq hired Osama bin Laden.
No,
so who's the leader?
Him. He hired him.
Who hid him?
Hired.
He hid him.
Yeah. Yeah. He hid him.
Where did he hid him?
In Pakistan.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Answer this question. You said the Ummah. What does the Ummah mean?
What does Ummah mean?
Yeah.
You know it very well.
No, you tell me.
You, the terrorist organization.
Alhamdulillah. Yeah. You see, that is not so Muslims. That is exactly what I'm telling you. That's not Muslims.
So they are creating all.
Thank you for
the
exposing yourself. Exposing yourself. Yeah. You see,
so they
that's why
are,
you should let them talk sometimes.
Nobody's pushing.
No.
So all those people. Let me ask you this. All those soldiers of Hitler.
No war.
All those soldiers of Hitler who are sleeping in the cemetery under a cross. Why?
We're not Christian.
Why are they sleeping under cross? Why? So they are doing the takfir. Look at them. They are doing takfir of all the people in the army.
Yes.
Yes? These people here are saying all the people who are in the army are not Christians.
They didn't believe any religion.
Are you saying Christianity doesn't say to kill? Have you read the Bible?
Yes, of course.
Have you read the Bible? Seriously, if you read Matthew 15, the New Testament, Jesus says anyone who curses the mother or father shall be put to death.
No, that's false. Say that? This is false.
Read it. Read it.
That's false.
Matthew 15, 3.
No, that's a parable. Is
manipulating. He is
butchering.
He is
butchering.
Show me.
He is lying.
He is
now you are lying.
He is butchering the
words.
Liar.
It's a parable.
No,
it's a parable.
He is butchering the words.
Look how angry they got.
No, that's because he's lying.
You just.
Why don't you read it?
Show me.
You just butchering the words.
He's a liar right now.
Okay, and
in front of everybody.
Okay.
All the Muslims have proved it.
And listen.
Jesus never told people to kill.
That's not easy. And if this is not a parable.
Jesus is of peace. He's not a monger.
Jesus says,
no, let him
Jesus says,
not going.
Jesus says,
the Bible, I know. I read the Bible.
No, you don't know the Bible.
You don't know the Bible.
Show me.
You don't know the Bible.
I'll show you, no problem.
Jesus never has lived before.
Don't put your religion into
look, yeah. The reason.
No. Now you're conflicting evil and religion.
Well, that is your Bible. That is evil, then you tell me. Okay. If it is true that you are a liar,
show me.
Good. We'll expose the liar.
Show me. I will prove he's a liar right now.
And
the parable which is talking
about. Yeah, I know.
The parable.
It's not a parable.
I'm saying Jesus.
Okay, here, listen to this.
Okay, come on, I will read it.
Read from the beginning. Let's see if it's a parable.
Then some Pharisees and teachers of the law.
Guys, let the lady listen.
Yes. Pharisees and teachers of the law.
Listen to this, that is the New Testament.
They were proud.
Stop interrupting. Have respect for your Bible.
Some Pharisees, teachers of the law came to Jesus from Jerusalem and asked, why do disciples break the tradition of the elders? They don't wash their hands before they eat. Jesus replied, and why do you break the commands of God? The sake of your tradition. For God said, honor your father and mother, and anyone who curses their father or mother is to put to death.
Put to death?
What Jews do, he's exposing. It's not
but
Jesus who's
telling.
He's not.
You said the parable.
Of course, it's not the father. It's a parable.
It's a parable.
He's exposing. Jesus never commanded. That's not a commandment.
Okay,
see, look, listen. This is how your people fool yourself.
Okay,
you are condemned.
I'm sorry.
That's another. Just what Jesus said.
I think I touched a nerve from
No.
What did you read here?
Said that. I proved it to you, Zalaya.
He
says Jesus just in front of everybody's eyewitness here. Stop fooling your people.
Can you stop?
No, I can't. You're lying. This is a proof of lie.
Okay. So you're saying, wait, listen to what Jesus said. No,
said
this is not Judaism. This is Jesus. Look, it's a red letter.
You don't read the context of
it.
Can I speak without you three getting all tied up in a knot? Okay, listen to this. What did Jesus say? And why do you break the command of God? What does command of God mean? He's not shouting now. Speak! What does command of God mean?
No.
Who is a liar? Who is a liar?
No, Jesus is telling
who. Who is a liar?
Jesus is telling who.
What liar?
Jesus is telling who.
Command of God means?
Jesus is telling who.
Command of God means?
People like you.
Command of God means what?
Jesus is telling people like you.
Command of God means what?
Okay, I will give it to you.
Answer.
Okay. Matthew 15:3, you read it yourself.
If
Jesus is telling the people to kill, or he's giving an example of murder, everybody accept Islam.
Don't worship pagan Allah.
Okay, wait a minute. By the way, this is, you know why? Let me educate this guy. He got very angry.
I can understand this.
Because he
said Jesus commanded to kill. That's not Jesus
that's what
commanded
he says.
To kill.
No. Who's saying this?
No. Example.
Who's saying this?
He's telling that Jesus, he's telling exposing Jews.
What
is for doing this? He's telling Pharisees, the bad Pharisees, telling people, you killed for people who
did
don't.
Did he say the command of God?
No, breaking the command of God. By killing exactly. people.
Yeah.
Killing people.
So basically, Jesus is telling the people like you.
Yeah.
People like you.
I'm not a Pharisee.
You are a Pharisee.
The reason
you are just like them.
You're telling me.
You are just like them.
Are you? You know what?
You're just like them. Ignoring the word of God.
You stoop down because you.
I know you are very hard.
No.
This is the effect. You know this. The Bible has an effect. Has such an effect on people who are brainwashed to think that Jesus only came for peace. When Jesus himself says he didn't come to bring peace, then he says it's a lie. Jesus, when he says from his own mouth, I've not come to bring peace, but to bring the sword, in Matthew 10:34, he says that's a lie.
When Muhammad is saying,
their own Bible,
when Muhammad is saying,
don't bring
that Satan caused a false revelation in my mouth.
You know why he got angry? Because he realized this is the command of God.
No.
This is the command of God.
When Muhammad himself is saying, Satan caused false revelation in my mouth. This is not a parable. It's the command of God.
Anybody wants
I just showed you.
Jesus
I just
never
you.
Any of
By the way, do you know where it comes from?
Never.
All
never.
The disciples killed them. Yes. Were killed.
You know why? You know why Jesus?
Yes.
They didn't even lift up a sword. Peter tried to lift the sword.
Doesn't matter.
Don't,
yeah.
don't do it.
Yeah.
Don't do it.
Jesus said it's a command of God. If you curse your mother,
peaceful religion.
No, it's not. That's
the salvation is.
We can see all the bonds coming.
This is the teaching of Jesus.
You know.
Jesus is the only person.
You know why? You know why he got angry?
Show one more.
The reason he got angry. Because he realized that Jesus in the New Testament says
never,
to kill.
Ever.
Yeah, I'm coming. So in the Bible, the reason
only Muhammad is start to kill
because he knows
only Muhammad is start to kill.
You can say anything against Muhammad, but we know who's in the war today.
And Muhammad,
let me ask you. All right, with all due respect, let me ask this lady.
Muhammad is start to kill today.
Who is the biggest guys? Stand down. Today, who is the biggest manufacturer of weapons of mass destruction?
Not Jesus Christ.
A Christian country or
Jesus
a Muslim
is
country?
Telling you to say that.
Tell me majority.
They buy them from Americans.
Today the biggest manufacturer of weapons is because the Christian country
is there any harm?
Yes.
Is there any harm?
I ask you the biggest.
Manufacturing.
The biggest manufacturer.
Is there any harm? Manufacturing.
Because they.
That's their business.
Wait a minute.
So that's their business.
Don't tell me to be quiet. No one will tell me to be quiet.
No. See?
Well, you are. You are being disrespectful.
That's their business. They have to
blame Americans for the good things they have done. I blame them. You know what? You know,
people in Saudi Arabia.
I will be the first one.
Listen.
I will be the first one to give credit to America for the good things they have done. But I will also be the first one to criticize them for the wrongs they have done. Okay?
What wrong?
Not to the degree of killing that has happened since America became independent, they have helped every single country in the world in terms of killing.
Is it a bad to help?
Of course they attack countries. What are you all about?
What reason?
Show me one.
We went to Iraq because Osama bin Laden.
Who's we?
Yes.
You know, I did not ask your opinion about what Jesus said.
You said
Christianity is a religion of peace. Did he say that or
not?
You said my religion is a religion of peace.
So I asked you, what is your religion doing?
Okay, so when Jesus says...
Because your religion is
supposed to
be on peace, but I see chaos.
No, you see chaos because of the outsiders who intervene in our country.
Iraq,
Afghanistan, all these countries, they were annihilated because of the Christians.
Only
I will blame other countries. Yes. Are you saying the war in Iraq is justified?
Only Muslim themselves.
Are you saying the war? Okay. So who brought the war?
Take responsibility for your own people.